All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Alen Paul Silverrstieen. He is the CEO of ImagineAR. And Alen Paul, it's always great to have you back. How are you?
For sure. And nice to see you as well. Beautiful day up in Vancouver as well down here. So nice to see you and join you for quite a new interesting chat this morning as well.
Yeah, it's very exciting. And also joining our conversation, I want to introduce from Forefront Development, Chris Eddy. Chris, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well. Thank you for having us on.
And we also have some royalty here. We have Sir JT Thompson as well, the founder of the Hip Hop Hall of Fame. And JT, nice to see you.
Nice to meet you and your audience as well.
Yeah, good stuff. Well, we're super excited about talking about ImagineAR's foray with the Hip Hop Hall of Fame. And we'll talk about the Hall of Fame in just a second and why that. But Alen Paul, maybe we could just begin with you. And can you give us sort of some thoughts on this now? We've talked a lot about sports. Now we're moving into a bit of the music scene.
Yeah, you were surprised that we came on this morning. I'm not wearing a jersey. I have another team. So it's a great change. And it shows the transition of where we're growing into. And had the opportunity through a mutual acquaintance to meet Chris Eddy, who, you know, is on this call as well, and introduce himself. And Chris was instrumental in bringing us to the Hip Hop Hall of Fame in this project and having the vision. And once JT, Sir JT and I hooked up and we started talking, he gets it again. And I know what you always say, when they get you, we're in trouble. And JT got the metaverse and we saw a tremendous opportunity to work together, delivering immersive experiential opportunities using our platform and delivering a global app that's really going to take the fan interaction, the engagement of hip hop stars, legends and fans and culture, and bring it all together and deliver it into the metaverse and into the hands of everyone. So this is an exciting deal. It brings us now into the museum world also, but also in a big way into entertainment and music. So we're quite excited by it, as you can see, by everyone who's involved.
Yeah. Chris, maybe you can tell us a little bit about Forefront Development and sort of the connection that you have with the Hip Hop Hall of Fame.
Sure. You know, for us as a company here in New York that, you know, we kind of mix, we go into different fields business. You know, one of them is real estate development, where we're working with JT, the Hip Hop Hall of Fame, but another is in the, you know, the tech space. And a lot of it, this project especially, we said to ourselves, we have a lot of different clients, and often we try and introduce clients to each other to make what they're doing more relevant. And I think this is a perfect marriage when you have hip hop, you know, grassroots American music, and this museum trying to really say, let's respect the history, the artists who created this genre. And then you have the relevancy that Steve brings in with AR of saying, you know, what's the future of this? What's the future of entertainment, the future of music? And how does the past and the present, you know, work together? And we think for the consumers of all age, I think hip hop especially sort of marries people of all different, you know, demographics and interests, and went from grassroots to being a global phenomenon. So I think, you know, Forefront's job in this case, apart from, you know, the real estate finance piece, it's a way to put really smart people together who can do something more amazing together than they can apart. And that's where this marriage came from.
Okay. JT, it's funny we're talking about this because I literally was in the car yesterday with my son and his friends and they were trying to play a bunch of rap songs. And I said, you guys, if only you knew the history of where all this came from. And that's what I think is so great about the Hip Hop Hall of Fame, is the fact that the music that we're hearing today is really built off of what we heard in the past. And maybe you could talk us through, you know, the rationale behind putting together the Hip Hop Hall of Fame and then sort of taking it from really what was the legacy and history of where music is today and now pushing it into the metaverse where we are in technology of today as well.
Let me just share this with you. Your kids are fascinating, the mere fact that they want to play some of the music. And you got to understand, you know, there is a rap culture and then there's a hip hop culture.
Yeah.
Rap culture is more of a commercial rap driven by industry, commerce, and sales. Hip hop is a culture phenomenon that includes not just rap artists and music and groups, but it also includes the DJs, the graffiti artists, the b-boy dancers. It also includes now scholarship and knowledge and education. It also includes business and fashion and entrepreneurship and all those other elements that make up the culture as a whole. So when you ask me to, you know, give you an idea, I mean, in the words of Grandmaster Caz, he always says hip hop didn't invent anything. We innovated everything and utilized things based upon what was available to us, whether it was poverty, lack of jobs, lack of real estate opportunities, lack of educational opportunities. By God, the kids in the Bronx, what they did is they plugged into the light pole, set up the DJ booth, and they had a party and had fun in the midst of poverty. That is the true essence of what hip hop is. putting up your bootstraps, doing the best you can with what you're working with to empower yourself, to uplift yourself and your communities. So you asked me what inspired the Hip Hop Hall of Fame for me personally. Being a Brooklyn born and Hollis Queens raised guy and a Harlem raised guy, my uncle who played with Billie Holiday, Louis Armstrong, and a lot of the greats, where they couldn't even stay in those places or eat in those places where they played, let alone own their own music and publishing. And as we fast forward to today, you see how important publishing is as venture capital firms and other hedge funds are now swapping up all of the publishing rights, right? So when I looked at that and I moved to California, it was a whole different transition as far as music and the type of music it was in hip hop and what rap was becoming. And so working on the LA Gang Truce at that time, bringing together for public and private partnerships with President Bill Clinton, Congresswoman Maxine Waters, and outreach, there was no funding for youth programs at that time. So I created the Hip Hop Hall of Fame, once again, out of the struggle of the moment, went back to New York City and did the TV special in the 1990s when no one was thinking about making hip hop cool or celebrating its history. And that's what we did on the TV show. And now the TV show's purpose was like the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, to take the TV show to actually build the actual Hip Hop Hall of Fame. But of course we ran into the tragic deaths of Tupac and Biggie at that time. So if you fast forward now, hooking up with guys like Chris Eddy and Forefront and a lot of the different people we're dealing with in the real estate community and the finance community and the real estate project that's coming to Penn Station, we're now not talking about a Hall of Fame. We're also talking about a hotel, residential, retail, and a full mega entertainment complex. So the world is changing. And now when you bring in Alen and ImagineAR, now we got the real world and the virtual world combining in that AR and VR experience for the future.
JT, you talked about innovating, and that's what hip hop artists were doing. And whether it's the graffiti artist, the musician, whatever it is, as you mentioned, they would find a way to get things done. And it sounds to me in what you're discussing there that no matter what happens, this is going to get done. Like you've got the passion to get this done, but also getting it into something that can attract, you know, my 11-year-old and other 11-year-olds around the world who are really focused on the metaverse and their phones and things like that, to really have this an immersive experience. Is that kind of what you're trying to get across?
I want to say the phenomenal technology of ImagineAR and Fame Days and what they're doing. We're going to revolutionize the whole cultural space. We're going to be the number one player in the space for hip hop. Utilizing this app and our metaverse prototype we already designed with Armand Studios and the creation of our NFT membership and other uses and utilities of it for products and services, for music, books, and films, and other things that we'll be utilizing it for. Can you imagine going into the cafe and gallery we're getting ready to open up in Harlem next year, and now you have a great AR, VR experiences that attracts those 12 to 17-year-olds, as well as the 18 to 24-year-olds demographic, but then we're all hip-hop's grandparents now, so you got the 25 to 55 as well. So we have to have something for everyone. So everyone might not be ready for the metaverse, but what ImagineAR gives us is a safe space entry point for us to bring our people into unique AR experiences, treasure hunts, different things that can be done on the app, and then from the real life experience with NFTs and the rest coming to live events and concerts, enjoying food and memorabilia, then, you know, they'll imprint a hologram of someone you can take a picture with at the actual cafe. You can see where I'm going with this. And now you got school kids coming through on field trips and they're seeing the history of hip hop from throughout the generations, all the way from Fight the Power era, all the way to Black Lives Matter, all the way to right now, whereas we're trying to move to an economic empowerment for all races and colors and creeds.
Yeah, absolutely. Makes so much sense. I tried to explain to my son yesterday about putting a boombox on your shoulder, and they just couldn't quite get it right because they've got their phone and they're thinking like, there you go. And they just couldn't quite get why they would do that. I said, yeah, sort of had to be there. But this is the experience where you could have it. You know, Chris is laughing. He knows what I'm talking about, right?
I know what you're talking about. I was there.
Yeah. How exciting is it to hear the way JT's talking about having the metaverse and the technology that's available, Chris, and something that you're helping to develop?
I think it's very exciting. I think, you know, when JT and I first got together, you know, the question we said was, it's great to build a museum, it's great to recognize the artists, but how are we affecting the community? You know, it's one thing to look back, but how do you look forward? So technology is part of how you look forward. What JT is saying is social empowerment, change. And so what I learned in, you know, our company where we help a lot of social causes is saying what JT said, you got to help yourself. End of the day, and communities. And so this project was born out of that bigger thought. or JT's like, wow, let's create housing, let's create jobs, let's create, you know, just this amazing possibility where people can have, you know, belief in, you know, their own future and the future of a community. And I think that to me is one of the most exciting parts of the project, you know, way beyond the business component.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. I don't know, guys, if no, Alan Paul's still with us. We should probably ask him a question. He's been sitting there for a while. Just enjoying the conversation. I'm a big music fan and I love Halls of Fames, and I'm just super excited about this and to go to this one for sure. Alan Paul, you talk about in the past, we've talked about, you know, how important the apps will be for sports teams and all that kind of stuff. But this is more of just that. This is what they were both talking about, the social change and connecting communities together. I think that's really, I don't think you ever thought about that when you were designing this, but it really is will make a huge impact.
Yeah, I just listening to JT, Chris, and the whole program, it gets me more excited and almost feel honored that we got selected to be part of this, to march together and really create this environment that's going to impact so many different lives and different age groups and deliver unique experiences. And certainly is, you know, we love sports and we love entertainment, but I think there's a bigger mission here altogether. And we're excited to be the platform of choice for this and to be honored to have Chris, you know, take us into this project. And for JT and I, we've been speaking quite a bit, and to be on the same page, to really go out there and, as we always say, change the world and put it in the hands of everyone around the world. So we're excited, as you said, Steve. The more I hear everyone, I'm getting very excited and thrilled, and more importantly, honored and emotional that we got involved in a project like this. So very excited and look forward to bringing it all to life at the end of this year as well.
Yeah. And lastly, just real quick, JT, what sort of the timelines you have for all of this?
Well, the way we're moving right now, and Chris and his team are working on financing on one of the actual projects we're working on right now, the Hip Hop Hall of Fame's Cafe and Gallery, we have a location in Harlem. We're working out the details now that can be opened within the next 12 months, so before summer, during Hip Hop's 50th anniversary, by the way, which will kick off a plethora of live events, a plethora of programming for education and community outreach, and it creates permanent jobs as well. And then you look at the app that will potentially be done over the next 3 months or whatever the case is, with a combined launch of that with some sort of NFT membership, VIP access credential with that. In spite of the marketplace right now, we just want to be that entry point into the space. And so The app also gives us the ability then to, you can tap from the app right into the NFT places that we'll be working with blockchain companies, as well as tap right into our metaverse place where you can come in for a virtual reality experience, or you can stay in the app and experience everything that Imagine and us are all working on together. So it's like it's an ecosystem that we're creating with the Harlem piece. The Penn Station development, it just got approved as far as the new Penn Station in New York City. There's 800,000 people come through there every day when it's up and running, and another 25 million will pass by the location where we'll be. So we have the potential now with this development with our joint venture partners, one of the development sites. We have a 50-story, 1.3 million square foot building designed by SOM Architects already. And now it's just a matter of gaining the right approvals from the state and Empire State Development to actually be able to develop our site, and then take that particular site and potentially break ground by late 2023 and open by late 25 or 2026. And that's the hotel, residential, retail, entertainment complex with an educational institute, as well as the Hall of Fame, co-owned by Hip Hop.
There you go. Who would have thought it all those years ago when artists were just doing it for the love? Now they've inspired this as well for generations to come. Gentlemen, thank you so much. It's been great to talking to everybody, and congratulations on all of this. JT, it's great to meet you. Thank you very much.
And I will say this, the Hip Hop Hall of Fame Award Show will be back in 2023 on national and international television.
Nice. Well, congratulations on it. Thank you so much. That's Sir JT Thompson, the founder of the Hip Hop Hall of Fame, and a number of other things as well. Chris, nice to meet you as well. Thank you very much.
As well. Thank you so much for your time, Steve.
There's Chris Eddy from Forefront Developments. And as always, Alan Paul, thanks for bringing us all together.
Sure. Thank you for conducting this, and can't wait till we get going. So thank you very much, everyone, and have a great week.
All right. There's Alan Paul Silverstieen, the CEO of ImagineAR.